Here we are at the Queen Victoria Market in Melbourne. I wonder if it was named after Queen Victoria because the food here is irresistible. As soon as you walk in, all your senses are heightened with the smells, colour, the sounds. Especially the characters. We are here today to shop for our international dinner guests. We are starting the night with pre-dinner drinks and nibbles. I think the days of gherkins, cheese and cabana on a toothpick are over. In fact, these days, all the food is dried or stuffed. So let's partake in the stuffed goodies. Oh, yum, look at those olives. Oh, and the bell peppers. Stuffed, of course. And we'll have some of that salami, and we may as well get the cheese for later, and some of that amazing bread that's not stuffed into a plastic bag. Now for the mains. Oh, hello, we've gone off track a bit here. I don't think we can eat these. Or roadkill? Could we? Minced? Spiced? Tarte? Pies? Now we're getting silly. But while we're here, let's get some souvenirs. How about a boxing kangaroo? Or those colourful bits of jewellery? Now that's what you call a devaluation of the Aussie dollar. Gotta get one of those and a footy scarf and an Aboriginal artefact, especially the ones that come back. Better pay for that. Is little Miss Muppet coming? Okay, stay focused. We are here to shop for dinner. Fish? To think it all came to this. No, can't do it to you. Those blue swimmers look fantastic. So do those mussels. And the chilies, capsicums. Perfect for our mains, bellissimo. We'd better get some wine. Let's finish dinner off with fruit and some chocolate stout. Better pay for that and home to cook. It's hardly an Aussie dinner, but it's a big feast. Oh, bum, who took that shot? Geez, that really spoils a good AV. We can't leave that in. This is a respectable club.